Howdy doodles. I'm EJ, you're you. Welcome to my channel. That was an intro. Today, y'all, we are going to be giving Victoria, our lovely little horse friend, a cute little farm. It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be desert. It's gonna be Wild West. So why don't you stick around and watch? Before we get into the video though, very crucial, if you haven't subscribed, do it. Just do it. Leave a like on the video if you like it. Leave a comment on the video. Let me know what you think. I have many prompts in this video for you. So if you're not sure what to comment, don't worry. Okay, let's get into it. You know, Victoria came to me. She said, hey. Why not give me a farm? And I said, okay, Victoria. I mean, you just got here, so I don't know why we're making demands, but, you know, cool, okay. So here we go. So we're going to give Victoria a farm. Now, if you were on my Friday stream last week, you probably saw, you know, the first, like, 4 or 5 minutes of this, but I definitely, like, this was a journey. I struggle. Okay, it's kind of funny to me because I feel like of my builds recently for this island, this has been one of the more straightforward, if you will. And it's interesting because this also was just like one of the most, I don't know, I struggled a lot with this build. Something about building this farm gave me a lot of trouble. It was really strange. I think part of it was because farms to me feel very full of life. You know, I wanted to say wet because, you know, people water things, but that feels wrong. So, you know, there's water on farms. And so I was like, what could she even grow? And so for a hot second, I was like, maybe I'll make it a horse farm. People on stream quickly were like, she's a horse and she has a horse farm. And I was like, okay, fine. If we're gonna make it weird, I'm not gonna do it. So I didn't do the horse farm, but I figured it out. I just looked up like what people actually grow in the desert, like what food people can grow in the desert, and, you know, just went with that. First step, obviously, is just placing down some fencing. I basically just gave myself a big part of this island to work with, just because I wanted to, you know, expand out and fill in some of this desert space. Even though it's like a desert, you know, we're gonna fill it with life. Farming. Ended with exactly 50, by the way. Used exactly 50 pieces of fence around to fence this area off. Was very proud of that. Also, this is fun because we have the intersection with the railroad. It's fun because, like, there's, you know, I feel like I have, like, all these different roads on my island right now, and it's exciting to me to see them all start to intersect in fun ways. So, you know, you love to see it. So with this pathing, I fully intended, like, when I was putting it down, I think I even on stream was like, I'm just going to put this down. It's just a temporary path because it's, like, very straight. So I was like, nah, kind of boring. But I actually didn't really change it too much from when I put it down. I actually don't think I changed it at all from basically once I stopped doing pathing. And, you know, I think it just kind of works. It's definitely like a big change from Ponderosa for me. I think that was another thing that I was really struggling with, in that, like, it's hard to cluttercore a farm. Like, you know, you have to have a big open field to have a farm. So, you know, that was just an interesting challenge for me. Also, customizing this freaking silo, nothing matched with Victoria's house. Look, disgusting. Which apparently is not even a Scottish accent that I'm doing. It's apparently Liverpoolian, apparently. Disgusting. There you go. Okay. And now, red roof, awful. I mean, better. Let's say it's better, but just didn't go. So I put it on the other side of the field. I was like, fine, if you guys aren't going to get along, let's put you far away from each other. And then this brick well, which, you know, it's okay. I also wasn't sure what to do with this. I wasn't sure what to put anywhere. I was like, I don't know. What is she building? I was still thinking it was going to be a horse farm. So I was just like throwing spaghetti at the wall, seeing what stuck. Is this phrase spaghetti, or is it the S word that I'm not going to say because, you know, monetization? I don't know what the phrase is. Comment down below if you know what the phrase is. But throwing stuff at the wall and seeing what sticks. Yeah. I don't know if it's spaghetti. And whatever. So then I decided I took a book out of, you know, Flynn Crossing on Instagram. I'll link to him down below. He is doing like a Midwest town, and it is very cute, and I loved it. And I definitely took some inspiration from that build that he did. Like, he just, like, it was literally just a country road, take me home. And I don't know, it was just beautiful. So I decided to take a page out of his book and do some wheat fields, some wheat up here. So yeah, she's got some wheat. And I decided to break up the monotony of the constant wheat by putting down some, you know, got a scarecrow, gonna put some other stuff there. It's gonna be great. Now, I basically found with this that, like, the key to this area is repeating things, but breaking up the repetition to add visual interest, but still having a lot of stuff. Also, look at the weeds, they grew. This was a whole thing. So, okay, so listen, I'm gonna share what I learned, because you know what? Maybe you will learn something too. So weeds. If you have more than 150 weeds that are on your island, your weeds will not grow in height, and they will not spawn more weeds, because, like, I guess Nintendo's like, we don't want to fill up your island with weeds, which is, like, fine, but I was, like, wondering, I was like, why are these weeds not freaking growing? Like, what am I doing wrong? And then I realized that the reason is because I had more than 150, because I had, like, my beaches were filled up with them. And then even after I, like, got the beaches done, I had to take them out of the canyon. It was annoying. And here, I'm talking about this, and I've missed other things. But basically, the point is, if you have more than 150 weeds, your weeds don't grow. So if your weeds aren't growing and you want them to grow, maybe check it out. Anyways, I put down a bunch of yellow tulips. Shout out to Joe. Joe gave me a bunch of these yellow tulips. Check out Joe on Twitch. Meow. And so I put down the yellow tulips and I ran through them. This is another idea that I got from Flynn Crossing. This is just really, I got a lot of ideas from Flynn Crossing for this build, apparently. Ran through them. They look like corn. Again, I don't really love these kinds of tricks, things, because, like, basically anytime I show off this island, I'm gonna have to run through the tulips to do it, but whatever. We'll do it for the dream address. It'll look like it'll be cute. Also, we put down some other things. Shout out to some of the people in my stream for giving me the idea to use the tree's bounty lamps as tomatoes. So tomatoes. You say tomato, I say tomato. And I say both, apparently. You know, ambidextrous in that way. It's not what that word means. So I used the tomatoes, and the cabbages also grow in the desert, so I put both of those down there. What was I even saying before? Oh, right. So the key to this area is having large sections of repetition with, like, interesting things to break it up. So instead of having one straight string of fencing, I broke up the fencing. I put, like, a bush in between it. I put a handcart. Instead of having just a field full of weeds, which, gorgeous, right? But, like, to add something to it, I put, you know, the wind turbine. I put the termite mound. And you'll see, like, the cornfield, cute, but I was like, what? I don't really like it. Like, what do I need to figure it out? Like, why isn't it working for me? And I figured out how to do it, change it. Do I figure it out now? No. But I will. And you'll see it. And you'll say, oh, yeah. And it speaks to that principle that I just was laying out for you. So we put down like, oh my gosh, I'm talking about things that like they already happened. But yeah, we made a little laundry area. I'll make it better in a second. But you know, I just tried to fill in around these area around the pathing. Again, the clutter core instincts. I have to have every single section filled up with something. Also, fun change is in that, like, previously, I feel like, at least on Ponderosa, I was always going for the pirate barrels. But on this island, I feel like the pirate barrels, like, don't fit. And I really like the normal barrels. I just wish they made the normal barrels also sideways, because I like the sideways pirate barrel for that reason. I wonder if you can customize them. I'll have to try out. You probably can. Don't take my word for this. Don't come for me in the comments also. Listen. I'm just talking, okay? You think I think about the things I talk about? No, I don't. I just talk. And then I cut it up. I say, YouTube, here. And they're like, really? And I'm like, yeah. And they're like, okay. Anyways, so I decided to move the scarecrow and move, make it a little bit more balanced with the termite mound in the middle, because I didn't like that the termite mound was directly in front of the wind turbine just because of the heights. So I put the log stakes in its place, and it's cute. And then we put the scarecrow down because I figured out that the reason I didn't like the corn was because it was just a straight thing and there was nothing that differentiated it. And I feel like breaking the pattern is what makes you appreciate the pattern. I don't know if that's really what this means, but there's probably some design person that can tell me why that is a thing. But I feel like it's just a thing. So there you go. And then I also decided to get rid of the top row and put fencing there to separate it from the rest of the path, which again, really worked in its favor. And I really like how the cornfield looks now. So now we're just putting down some other patterns. We're putting down some stone. We're putting down some flowers. We're making it look pretty and filling up the grass. And then I decided to, you know, decorate a little bit of the area, the entrance, as it were. Again, I like the idea. One of my favorite things about like driving in the countryside or whatever is like you drive down these streets and you see the mailboxes right at the street and these long driveways going off into the distance. So I really like wanted to kind of do a nod towards that. Although I think that her mailbox would probably be along the rest of the street, but whatever. And then a little tunnel. Look, we did a little tunnel. This design, it's just a panel. It's just a simple panel. I customized what I made an all black pattern, and I just customized the simple panel with that. It's nothing special. But yeah, put that there, stone arch in front, and now you got a tunnel. Cute. Secret tunnel. Anyways. So I wanted to connect Victoria to, you know, civilization. So I decided to extend our lovely little country road, take me home towards her home. And so I made a few different variations of the gravel path. But the gravel path, I'm actually not going to upload quite yet to my design portal or whatever, because some people in stream on Friday last week were like, I don't know if I like this pattern. And I was like, I kind of like it. I don't know. So I want to hear what you guys think. And I'm sure people are going to be like, well, if you like it, like you should use it. But like, you know, I just want to know, should it be like redder? Should it be darker? Does it blend in? I don't really think it blends in. I kind of like that it's like a lighter gravel because I feel like it's like sun bleached, you know, but I don't know. Let me know down below. And, that'll be that. Lots of comment calls. Ooh, YouTuber. But here we go. Here's the finished thing. It's such a simple area. I just kind of, it's like funny because when I was doing the walkthrough, I was like, oh, this is like really quick. But like for some reason, it just gave me so much trouble. But I really like how it turned out. I actually really just enjoy, again, it feels different from the other sections of my island, but it still feels like it's part of the same island in like a good way thematically. And I like how it turned out. So I hope Victoria does too. She wasn't here to see it, but you know, But thank you guys again for watching to the end of another speed build. If you guys like this video and you're not subscribed, why not just subscribe so you can see the next one and you can see more of these Wild West builds. And, you know, come back, come see me in the next one. Oh, wait, question. Right. So if you watch to the end of the video, I always ask a little question. Answer it down below to let me know that you watched to the end. Today's question is going to be, if there was a zombie apocalypse in Animal Crossing, what are the three villagers that you want to have on your team to fight against the zombies with? Answer down below. This seems like a fun one, right? I don't know. We'll see. And I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, have a howdy day. I have...